vamos a iniciar con Jordaniel Abreu. Adelante, Jordaniel.
Buenas noches, Michael. Good evening, Dave. Good evening. Today was the debut of Vladimir Guerrero Jr. What was your first impression of him now that he has prepared his physique and have the goal of contributing Leones del Escogido?
It is always a pleasure to see players at every level, but it's, that come and play for Escogido, but especially when they're at the big league level and they're on the cusp of being big time players in the big leagues, because they get to improve their craft down here while helping a club win down here. And that's what we saw Vladi in the dugout, what we saw Vladi in the batter's box. He competed, he joined with the team, and it was a pleasure to have him here.
La pregunta que hace Jordaniel, la impresión que se lleva el dirigente sobre Vladimir Guerrero Jr., que debutó hoy, dice que siempre es un placer ver a los jugadores que participan con el Escogido, la forma en que compiten, pero tiene un sabor especial también ver a jugadores como Vladimir Guerrero Jr., que vienen de grandes ligas, a querer trabajar con el equipo, a sumar al equipo. Le gusta verlo cómo se comporta en el clubhouse, cómo está en la caja de bateo también, en las prácticas, y que en general es un placer verlo jugar por el nivel de compromiso que presenta cuando está participando con los Leones. Vamos con Rafael Padilla, adelante.
Saludos, Rafael Padilla, Prensa y Deportes y Team Deportivo RD. Sí, nos gustaría saber cómo recibieron a Vladimir Guerrero Jr., si de una vez tuvo la integración con el equipo y cómo lo trataron. También qué partes, perdieron el partido, qué entienden que deben de mejorar para ganar la próxima vez contra las Estrellas.
Well, he asked if we prepared some special reception for Vladimir Guerrero, and we lose tonight, and what do you think we have to improve for the next games?
Well, every day you want to improve, and you take away what you need to do the next day, regardless of the result today. And what we saw today is we got good pitching, we played good defense, gave up a couple home runs, got to keep the ball in the park. And then offensively, we had a couple chances, some guys on base early, a guy at third with less than two outs. You got to get those runs across. And situational hitting is important. Two-out RBIs are important. And again, 1-9 is important. You don't create an offense because of one player on the team. You don't create an offense because of hitting only home runs. You create an offense by having a 1-9 lineup, guys ready to come off the bench, good at-bats, base running, timely hitting, and situational hitting.
Dice que el tema de la derrota, siempre hay cosas que mejorar en el equipo cada día, y lo hemos dicho constantemente en los encuentros anteriores. Hoy no se pudo batear, el bateo situacional pues no fue el mejor esta noche, no se pudieron hacer carreras, no porque un jugador no hizo carreras, sino porque en general no se pudo producir con la alineación que se tuvo hoy, y que eso es lo que trata siempre, tener una alineación que permita generar carreras, no solamente a través de un jugador con un cuadrangular, sino con el bateo situacional. Y que de la parte de hoy, aunque se perdió el partido de hoy, pues resalta el buen resultado del cuerpo de lanzadores, los pitchers, con una buena labor esta noche, al igual que la defensa, que estuvo haciendo un muy buen trabajo. Arvin González pregunta: how are you going to deal with the downs in the starting rotation, Lowy, then G. Reyes, and Eni Romero?
Lowy, and then who's the other guy you mentioned?
Denji Reyes.
Oh, Denji Reyes. Well, you know, Lowy threw tonight on short rest. I thought he did a really good job. He had a really good fastball. So he was plenty rested because it was a short outing last time in San Francisco, and he did a really good job. He competed, misfired a couple pitches, breaking ball that Leyva took out, and a fastball that stayed down in Junior Lake's swing path. So he did what he needed to do so that we didn't have to expose our bullpen early after going with a bullpen day yesterday. Denji Reyes has got to get healthy. So we don't have him in our plans until he gets healthy, because the most important thing is that he's healthy to help us win, and then also that he's healthy so he can go to spring training and compete the way he has competed here. We go day to day. I know Kubiak's starting tomorrow, and I know that on Thursday I got a better chance to start than anybody else because it's an off day. And so Kubiak's going to give us a really good outing tomorrow. We'll use the rested bullpen we have. We go one day at a time. We have some plans on who we're going to use, and getting them lined up. When they know when they're going to be used, you guys will know.
Dice que en el caso de Lowey, pues estuvo lanzando a pesar de un corto descanso, estuvo lanzando de manera efectiva. La recta, la bola rápida estuvo funcionando bastante bien esta noche. No quiso utilizar el bullpen temprano en el partido porque está muy trabajado del día de ayer, que tuvimos un día de bullpen. En el caso de Denji Reyes, pues dice que tiene que estar saludable completamente, pues no queremos exponer ningún jugador que no esté saludable 100% por el bien de su carrera, y que mañana sabe que va a Kubiak, contamos con la labor de Kubiak para conseguir esa victoria de mañana. Tenemos una pregunta de Jordaniel Abreu, adelante.
Dave, two bullpen veterans, left-handers, Edward Paredes and Ramon Garcia also made their debut, their season debut tonight. Have you already heard of them and what they represent to El Escogido?
That's a really good question, and I got a good story for you. Before I say the story, though, they did exactly what you want out of any reliever. They turn out to be lefties, but they threw strikes and they competed and they kept us in the game, which is great. I did go out to the mound to bring Garcia in, and Sully, our catcher, who just got here this week, as Garcia's coming in, goes, hey, Skip, what's he got? And I said, this is winter ball at its finest. When he throws his first pitch, it'll be the first time I ever see him. And it's a joy. It's a joy to see guys compete. It's a joy to see guys have fun and then have some results, because it's not easy to go out there and compete and put things on the line. And even without fans in the stands, they're watching. And so it was a lot of fun to see. I know Paredes from a long time now, but Garcia, I probably have seen him before, but I didn't remember that, and I hadn't seen him yet this year. And so it was great. So I hope you enjoy the story.
Okay, dice que tuvo una salida al box en un momento con Sullivan y con García. Y dice que pues le gustó la manera en que conversaron, porque se vio la manera competitiva en que están tratando de llevar el partido, y le gusta la manera en que compiten nuestros jugadores, y también la manera en que se llevan entre ellos. Tenemos una pregunta de Enrique Ramírez para concluir. Adelante.
Good night, Mr. Yaos. I think that in this league, the RBI is more important than in MLB. How do you work that aspect as a manager?
You're wise, because I do believe even in the MLB, RBIs are important. Some people can drive in runs. Sometimes the runs are driven in. But as much as you know the guy that touches home plate and they talk about runs scored, they have to be driven in by somebody. And in a league where it is a pitcher's league and pitcher's parks, RBIs count. And so the approach that you have when the opportunities arise to drive in runs has to be even developed and talked about even more, and have some fortitude and desire to drive in that run. And our guys are coming along. It's a process though, because there's only a few Eddie Murrays in the world that knew how to drive in runs every time they were out there. And Eddie Murray didn't become Eddie Murray until 6 to 8 years into his career. And so it's a developing mentality and ability to do it. And I believe our team is going to do it, because the last few days until today, we had started to produce some runs. So I see that happening for the Escogido team.
Y sobre el aspecto, la pregunta que le hace de que él considera que aquí en la Liga Dominicana es más importante el aspecto de las carreras remolcadas más que en Estados Unidos. Nuestro dirigente dice que las carreras impulsadas son importantes aquí y también en Estados Unidos, porque siempre es importante traer carreras al plato, llevar a los corredores que están en circulación, llevarlos a anotar. Y que al final eso es lo que cuenta, sobre todo en una liga como esta donde hay... Es una liga donde hay un picheo muy fuerte, es una liga de un muy buen nivel de picheo, y también donde el factor parque también favorece a los lanzadores. O sea que la importancia de producir carreras, no importa si es en Estados Unidos o si es en Dominicana, pues es un valor agregado que puede sumar cualquier equipo y que no le molesta a nadie. Entonces, muchas gracias. Thank you very much, Mr. Giles, for your time. Y será hasta un próximo encuentro de los Leones del Escogido. Buenas noches.
Have a good night. Thank you.